Hello, everybody. My name is Mark Mello, and I'm a park ranger with Blackstone River Valley National Historical Park. And I would like to welcome you to Season 2 of our Ranger Chats here in the Blackstone River Valley. And we're super excited to continue these for the next 10 weeks, in which we'll talk once again a little bit more about those lesser-known stories in the history of the Blackstone River Valley. This week, we're going to talk about what is an important anniversary today, the 170th anniversary of the first National Women's Rights Convention, which was held in Worcester, Massachusetts. In 1848, about 300 people, predominantly women, attended what most consider the first Women's Rights Convention in the United States of America at Seneca Falls, New York. This two-day conference famously produced the Declaration of Sentiments, a document which played upon the Declaration of Independence to state the unjust ways in which women were treated. Today, the site of this conference is preserved as Women's Rights National Historical Park. Although this conference is arguably the most famous women's conference ever in the United States, it was largely a regional affair and was attended by a relatively small group of activists. The series of conferences which ensued every year from 1850 to 1860 were much larger affairs and were actually considered national conventions. The first of these national conventions was held on October 23rd and 24th, 1850, in the Blackstone Valley's own Worcester, Massachusetts. Nearly 1,000 people were in attendance. The convention was held at Brinley Hall on Main Street. The building no longer stands, but stood roughly across the street from where Mechanics Hall is. One of the first resolutions of the convention indicated its purpose, quote, "To secure for women political, legal, and social equality with man, until her proper sphere is determined by what alone should determine it, her powers and capacities, strengthened and refined by an education in accordance with her nature." End quote. This convention was also the only one of its day to pass resolutions linking the struggle for racial justice with the struggle for women's rights. The convention was attended by some of the leading civil rights activists of the day. Among the speakers were William Lloyd Garrison, William Henry Channing, Wendell Phillips, Antoinette Brown, Sojourner Truth, Lucretia Mott, Lucy Stone, and Frederick Douglass. The Valley's own Stephen Foster and his wife, Abby Kelly Foster, also gave speeches. In an impassioned plea, Abby Kelly Foster proclaimed, "Bloody feet, sisters, have worn smooth the path by which you come hither." A contingent from the Hopedale Commune were also in attendance. This convention had international impacts. After reading a report from the New York Tribune's European edition, women in Sheffield, England petitioned the House of Lords for women's suffrage. And at home, this first national convention sparked an annual tradition. For the next 11 years, a national convention was held. The second convention, held the following October, was also in Worcester. The first national convention served as a major turning point in the women's rights movement. As women became more vocal about their desire to receive equal rights, the movement gained more followers. However, the events of the American Civil War would diminish the movement's progress. The last national convention was held in 1860, just mere months before the outbreak of the war. It would take six more decades before women won the right to vote, and even longer to acquire other rights denied to them. In some ways, the battle continues to this day. As we celebrate the centennial of the passage of the 19th Amendment this year, on this 170th anniversary of that first national convention, we remember those bloody feet that have got us to where we are today. I'd like to thank you for joining us today. If you have any comments or questions, please leave those down below. We would love to hear from you. And as always, stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll see you out there along the Blackstone really soon.